The qualifying graduate program report will help ensure that we're identifying the right students for your student level reporting, define which students need to have that extra year of data reported, and help streamline some of the reporting for your program level report. So for the department, a qualifying graduate program is a program in certain fields where postgraduate training requirements apply for licensure. There are certain graduate programs, mostly in the medical or clinical fields, that have this initial period where the student is going to make less money or less earnings because they have to complete this postgraduate clinical or residency work in order to obtain their professional licensure. And then after they've done that postgraduate or clinical work, their earnings will go up significantly. And so the department has basically given your institution this additional year to account for that. My brother went to school for dermatology. He completed his residency. He's in the Army right now. He makes very little and made very little through his residency, but now he's being courted by all of these large private medical organizations making 10 times as much as I will ever make in my entire life. So that is really what this is to account for, is they want to make sure that that period of residency where there are these depressed earnings, they give you that grace so that the student has that extra year of that residency or postgraduate time, and then the earnings come through once that student gets through there. And so that's what gets calculated into the debt and earnings information. In this qualifying graduate program report, we give your institution the opportunity to declare which programs at your institution are qualifying graduate programs. So we are on the landing page for FVT and GE. In the Before You Begin section, the first tile is this Review Qualifying Graduate Program. Click on this, and it's going to provide you with a pop-up. This pop-up is going to tell you what we're going to use as qualifying graduate program information for. This is going to help inform your standard student level report. So if you're reporting the standard cohort to us, this is where we're going to pull in that additional year of data for you to make sure that it accounts for that period of depressed earnings. In addition, we're going to use the information that you provide here to populate that data element that is required in your program level report. So you're only reporting it once. We will transition the qualifying graduate program flag over to the program level report that requires that same information. If you're choosing to report the transitional file to us, this is not required because you're not going to be reporting that additional year of data. You're just reporting the most recent 2 years of data. The caveat there is that if you don't complete this, we won't be able to populate it on your program level report, and your institution will need to manually populate that or populate it when you send back the licensure fields to us. If you want to complete this report, click accept, and it's going to take you to a screen that's very similar to the screens that you've been working on for the completers list. We're going to provide you with instructions, including what a qualifying graduate program is, give you the list published in the Federal Register and the announcement that talks about the QGP. And then there's a list of all of the various qualifying graduate programs. There are two primary categories: the clinical psychology, marriage, family counseling, clinical social work, and clinical counseling category, and the medicine, osteopathy, and dentistry categories. You can filter by category or filter by the 4-digit zip code family or 6-digit zip code. You can also filter by program title or by credential level. In this first iteration, we are going to give you all programs that are on the Federal Register. All you need to do is identify which programs at your institution are considered qualifying graduate programs requiring that additional licensure or residency training. So make sure your institution offers a program and that it is a qualifying graduate program for your institution. And then you're going to select those, click Confirm QGP. It's going to give me this confirmation that my updates have been successfully applied. It's going to move those over to this confirmed qualified graduation program list. If I want to revert something back, I can do that. There's also a does not qualify list where there are these other programs, either they're not programs at my institution or they are programs, but they're not qualifying graduate programs. You can also download the list of qualifying graduate programs, and it's going to tell you which ones you've marked as confirmed or does not qualify for your institution. Once you are done with your review, you'll mark this section as complete. And that is the information that we will use. If you plan to use the standard student level report, we will pull that additional year in for those programs. If you are using the transitional, we will leverage that information for the program level report, because there is a field on the program level report that requires you to declare whether or not a program is a qualifying graduate program. Coming back to the landing page, the QGP reports have been closed out with the check mark, and you'll be able to view your qualifying graduate programs list